Hi everybody, this is Nick. I'm coming to you with a really quick PowerPoint trick, a little hack that you are going to love, especially if you use PowerPoint for creating longer form reports or slide docs, reports that need to have a table of contents slide. We know that PowerPoint is not as great for us as Word when it comes to putting in an automatic table of contents. You're gonna have to do this manually, but I have a little bit of a trick that will make it a little bit more elevated. It'll make it just a little bit more perfect for your reader to look at here. So here's kind of an example of a table of contents that I would normally set here. I have my section, names right here, and then the page numbers, and then these leader lines, which are just periods. So that's what most of the time I think I see people do, is we're just going to push the period key and kind of hold it across until it gets a little bit close, kind of an eyeball there, an approximation of how close it gets to the other leader lines, and then just push the tab key over, and that at least gives us a nice vertical axis of orientation here, a left alignment along those page numbers, but the leader lines never get that perfect. And they're never going to be perfect because the amount of text and the character spacing that we have over here on the left is always going to be different. You're never going to have the exact same section headers for the entire way down the table of contents. So here's a little trick that we can use to make those table of contents just a little bit more perfect. I see that my 10 is down here. I'm gonna do this just so that we can do this for the demonstration. So go ahead, right now you're gonna need to make sure that there's a space, a single space between your section header text and the number. I'm just gonna keep my cursor right there, and then all you're gonna do is launch the font dialog launcher right here. Under the underline style, right now it's selected as none. We're gonna go ahead and select any of these that you want. I'm gonna go ahead and use this one. It's the dash heavy line. I'm gonna go ahead and say okay. And now I'm gonna click the tab key. And now I basically just created this underline text style, and I'm just gonna tab over, and I'm gonna do the exact same thing for the next section. Font dialog, underline style, heavy dash, okay, tab over. Now if I wanted to make this just a little bit faster, what I could do is I could go ahead and just tab my numbers over to what I want them to be, to the positioning that I want them to be. So I'm just gonna go ahead and tab these all down. Make sure that they're all left aligned right there. Perfect. That's a nice feature of this tab key here. You can set the distance of the tab key in the settings of the text box if you don't want to use the default. But that looks really nice. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the format painter to create those leader lines. So right here, I'm just going to double click anywhere in the middle of one of the lines, the leader lines that I've already created. Go up here to the format painter. I'm going to double click the format painter. That keeps it activated. So now I can select multiple selections on my slide and it will apply that formatting to them. So I'm just going to go ahead right here with my cursor and I'm going to drag across. Perfect. Drag across. And now you can see my leader lines are applying. Oops. Uh-oh, that's good. We'll see if that works right there. Sometimes it's gonna be a little bit wonky. There we go. And perfect, right here. Oops, wanna make sure that that stays right there. Don't wanna get any of that word underlined. There we go. Now I'm gonna unselect the format painter there, and now put this in slideshow mode. You have a beautiful table of contents slide, and those leader lines are perfectly spaced. They're perfectly spaced right from the left to the end, from the right side of your section header text all the way over to your page number. So if you like this video, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up. Make sure to click the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.